saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that
Welcome to the Word of God Online. Today is April 6, 2009, and the topic is our earthly bodies versus our heavenly bodies from the Living Bible, April 6, 2009. Scripture verse of the day is 2 Corinthians 3:18. We Christians have no veil over our faces. We can be mirrors that brightly reflect glory, the glory of the Lord. And as the Spirit of the Lord works within us, we become more and more like Him. Scripture reading of the day is 1 Corinthians 15:35 through 58. But someone may ask you, how will the dead be brought back to life again? What kind of bodies will they have? What a foolish question. You will find the answer in your own garden. When you put seed into the ground, it doesn't grow into a plant unless it dies first. When the green shoots come up out of the seed, it is very different from the seed you first planted. First of all, you put into the ground is a dry little seed of wheat or whatever it is you are planting. Then God gives it a beautiful new body, just the kind He wanted to have. A different kind of plant grows each kind of seed. And just as there are different kinds of seeds and plants, so also are there different kinds of flesh. Humans, animals, fish, and birds are all different. The angels in heaven have bodies that are different from ours, and the beauty, their beauty and the glory of their bodies is different from the beauty and the glory of ours. The sun has one kind of glory, while the moon and stars of another kind. And the stars differ from each other in their beauty and brightness. In the same way, our earthly bodies, which die and decay, are different from the bodies we shall have when we come back to life again. For they will never die. The bodies we have now embarrass us, for they become sick and die. But they will be full of glory when we come back to life again. Praise God. Yes, they are weak, dying bodies now, but when we live again, they will be full of strength. They are just human bodies at death, but when they come back to life, they will be superhuman bodies. There are also supernatural, spiritual bodies. The scripture tells us that the first man, Adam, was given a natural human body, but Christ is more than that, for He was life-giving spirit. First then, we have the human bodies, and later on, God gives us spiritual, heavenly bodies. Adam was made from the dust of the earth. Christ came down from heaven above. Every human being has a body just like Adam's, made of dust. But all who become Christ will have the same kind of body as His, a body from heaven, just as each of us now has a body like Adam's. So we shall someday have a body like Christ. I can tell you this, my brothers, an earthly body made of flesh and blood cannot get into God's kingdom. These perishable bodies of ours are not the right kind of body to live forever. But I'm telling you this strange and wonderful secret. We shall not all die. But we shall all be given new bodies. It will all happen in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. When the last trumpet is blown, there will be a trumpet blast from the sky, and all the Christians who have died will suddenly become alive with new bodies that will never die. And then we who are still alive shall suddenly have new bodies too. For our earthly bodies, the one we have now, will die. But we must be transformed, our new bodies must be transformed into heavenly bodies that cannot perish but will live forever. When this happens, then at last the scripture will come true. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where then your victory? Where then your sting? For sin, the sting causes death, will all be gone. And the law, which reveals our sin, how we thank God for all of this. It is He who makes us victorious through Jesus Christ our Lord. So, my dear brothers, since future victory is sure, be strong and steady, always abounding in the Lord's work. For you know that nothing you do for the Lord is ever wasted. as it would be if there were no resurrection. Well, my response to this is that we live in a current society where the outward appearance of our bodies are constantly scrutinized, to the point where now there are all sorts of surgeries and even industries that have cropped up to make us look better on the outside. Our kids, who are growing up in this generation, are completely bombarded by this message that we have to look incredible on the outside to be loved. This is so twisted and so far from the truth that it is in direct opposite to what God says. We all deal with this one in one way or another, as our earthly bodies are in a state of deterioration. In the above scripture, it is shared with us that when the time comes, we will have new bodies. They will be different than the ones we currently have. There is a mystery to this that will not be answered until that day comes. But from Paul's description above, we can take a few things out of that scripture and begin to understand what that will look like when the day comes. So much time, energy, effort is put into the external part of our beings here on earth that often we are distracted away from true beauty, which can only be found inside of us. It has nothing to do with the color of our skin, the length of our hair, how much we weigh, how big our breasts are, or how many wrinkles we have on our skin. None of that matters. It's not where our beauty in Christ lies. I like the description above that says when we live again, they will be full of strength. It also says they will be superhuman bodies. I think it is really hard to get our mind around this and actually picture what these new bodies will be like, you know, but that's okay. The day will come when this occurs. For more readings, you can go to wordofgodonline.com. I'd love to hear your feedback, and feel free to post comments on the blog or on the below the video, and let's get some discussion going and wonder what this mystery of our new bodies is really going to be like.